everybody. Welcome back to camp. I have Mr. AJ and Mrs. Trout helping me out today. And if you don't already know Mrs. Trout, she is one of our Sunday school coordinators for the pre-K through second graders. Today we are continuing to talk about how soul power is greater than our trials. We saw that with Job on Monday when Mr. AJ taught us. And then yesterday with Miss Trish, we saw that God is greater than our trials through Naomi's story. Today, Mr. AJ is going to teach us how Jonah learned that God is greater than our current trials. Jonah comes from the book Jonah in the Old Testament. So it's the first half of the Bible again. In terms of trials, Jonah had a lot, right? Some of his trials were due to his own actions, but some were also due to God teaching him or even protecting him. He realized that God was punishing him with the big storm when he was on the boat, but when he got swallowed by the whale, I'm sure that he was thinking, oh yay, this is just how I thought that would end, right? No, he was probably thinking, what is going on? Well, what would have happened if he'd stayed in the ocean? He probably would have drowned. So what Jonah, and probably us, would see as just another smack in the face, God was using that trial to save and protect him from something different. It would probably be worse to drown. I am so glad that just like our verse said on Monday, God's plans are so much bigger and better than what we can fathom. So glad that we can rest in him when we get thrown overboard during a raging storm, and when we get swallowed by a whale. It's hard, but I'm very glad that he is in control. The verse that we're practicing today with Mrs. Trout is Ephesians 2, 8, and 9, which says, "For it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast." Again, God's got this, and he's the one who does the saving. If it was up to me and my good deeds, I would never get to God, because our good deeds are like filthy rags to him. So let's bow our heads and close our eyes and talk to the God who is in charge of everything. Father, we thank you so much that you don't change. We thank you that you are in charge. We thank you that you can help us through our trials. And we pray that you would help us remember that when it's hard. We love you, and we pray that you would watch over us today. Amen. Okay. We are going to sing Fruit of the Spirit again and Dancing on the Waves. So go ahead and stand up so you can dance along with the songs.
Well, the fruit of the Spirit's not a coconut. The fruit of the Spirit's not a coconut. If you want to be a coconut, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Oh, the fruit of the Spirit's not a banana. The fruit of the Spirit's not a banana. If you want to be a banana, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Oh, the fruit of the Spirit's not a watermelon. The fruit of the Spirit's not a watermelon. If you want to be a watermelon, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Oh, the fruit of the Spirit's not a cherry. The fruit of the Spirit's not a cherry. If you want to be a cherry, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, because fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Oh, the fruit of the Spirit's not a strawberry. The fruit of the Spirit's not a strawberry. If you want to be a strawberry, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Okay! Grapes coming! nuts and getting great big bunches. Here we go. Fruit of the Spirit's not a grape. The fruit of the Spirit's not a grape. If you want to be a grape, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Well, the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Well, the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control.
Jesus Christ in me. Welcome, guys, to 4C Kids Camp. We're in our message portion of the day, and we have been talking about soul power and how it's greater than our trials. We talked about Job on Monday, and we talked about Naomi and Ruth yesterday. And today, we're going to talk about Jonah. Now, a lot of you might know the story of Jonah, Jonah and the whale, Jonah and the big fish. So if you have your Bibles, go ahead and open it up to the book of Jonah. It's kind of near the middle, a little bit past the middle of your Bible. And we'll get started. So in the book of Jonah, we see that he is called by God to go to Nineveh. And Jonah doesn't really want to go. We see that he kind of disobeys God. And the first thing he does is he says, "No, God, I'm not going to go to Nineveh. They'll hurt me if I go and tell them about you." And so Jonah decides to kind of get on this boat. And they're on the boat. And then while he's on the boat, it starts storming. While it's storming, there comes rain, there comes thunder, there comes big waves, and it's rocking the whole ship. And everyone on the boat is wondering, well, why is it storming like this? Why is it storming? And they're thinking, well, someone must have done something to upset God. Someone must have done something, or else he wouldn't be causing this big storm to happen. So everyone kind of sees what's going on, and they ask Jonah, "Hey, did you do something?" And Jonah says, "You know what? Yeah, I did. And you guys don't deserve this to happen to you. Go ahead and throw me over the boat. And that way the storm will end." So it was kind of a kind thing for Jonah to do. He didn't have to tell them the truth, but he chose to be obedient and to tell the truth that he had disobeyed God, and that's why the storm was happening. So the sailors of the boat kind of put him off the boat, and he's in the water, and suddenly the storm stops. But after the storm stops, big, big fish comes and swallows Jonah up. And he's so big that he gets to live in the belly of the fish. Now, some people think it's a whale. The Bible doesn't say exactly what kind of fish it was. It's assumed to be a whale because that's the only fish that's big enough to swallow Jonah. But who knows? God could have used a giant goldfish if he wanted to swallow Jonah. So Jonah's living inside this whale. And while he's in there, he sort of prays to God, and he says, "God, I'm sorry for what I did. Lord, please forgive me. I should have listened to you. But Lord, if you get me out of this, if you get me out of this whale, I promise I'll go to Nineveh like you want me to. I promise I'll listen to what you say." And what do you think God did? What do you think God did for Jonah? That's right. He had the whale, the big fish, spit Jonah out. He spit him onto land, and Jonah lived inside that fish for 3 whole days. Can you imagine living inside of a fish for 3 days? That's a long time. But after he was done living inside the fish, he was spat up on the shore safe and sound. God had taken care of him in the fish. And then Jonah ends up going to Nineveh and tells them about God. And those people in Nineveh ask for forgiveness, and God shows mercy on them. So what do we learn? I mean, what do we see here? Jonah went through a real trial. Not only was he swallowed by a fish, but he had to deal with a big storm. He had to go to Nineveh, where people might want to hurt him. And what we see about God is that he had a plan for Jonah all along. He knew that Jonah wouldn't go to Nineveh, and he was going to use that giant fish to get him to listen. God had never planned to harm Jonah, but he was teaching him. He was teaching him that I'm the one that's going to save you. I'll save you from this fish. And so what we learn from the story of Jonah is we should listen to God. We should listen to God, and when he tells us to do something, we should do it. And God tells us to do a couple of different things, like the Ten Commandments: obey our parents, to not lie, to obey the authorities, that we should not hurt other people, that we shouldn't steal, that stuff like that. We should follow God's commands that he's given us. And we can also learn from Jonah that he asked for forgiveness, and we need to do the same thing. Sometimes we need to ask for forgiveness when we do something wrong. And now all of us have done something wrong in our life. Think about maybe you didn't always obey your parents. Maybe they asked you to clean your room and you didn't, or they asked you to be quiet and you kept being rambunctious and loud. That was always my issue as a kid. I was always a little too loud. So I need to ask for forgiveness when I was a kid for not obeying. And what we all need to do, not just ask for forgiveness from our parents, but we need to ask forgiveness from God for our sins. That, you know, God wants to forgive us, but we need to ask for his forgiveness. And if we ask, he surely will forgive us. So if we want to, you know, be forgiven by God, we need to ask him, God, would you forgive us? So if you've never done that, this is a great chance to do that right now. God, would you forgive us? Just ask him that right now. God, would you forgive me for the wrong things that I've done? I'm sorry. I'm sorry for disobeying. So a couple questions to ask. Why was Jonah swallowed by the big fish? Why do you think Jonah was swallowed by the fish? And then how is Jonah's prayer similar to accepting Jesus as our Savior? What did Jonah do in his prayer that makes it similar to what we have to do? So think about those questions, think about them, and take a moment right now and just pray and ask God to forgive you of your sins if you've never done that.
Good morning, boys and girls. I'm so glad to see you today. I can't wait to go over the Bible verse that Abby and I have been practicing this morning. Yeah, Abby's my granddaughter and I'm Mrs. Trout. And today we are going to practice a verse from the book of Ephesians, another book in the New Testament. It's a big word, isn't it, Abby?
Yep.
Ephesians 2, verses 8 and 9. So listen along. For it is by grace that you have been saved through faith. And this is not from yourselves. It is the gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast. So let's try that together, okay? Abby's going to say it with us too.
Yep.
So here we go. Ephesians 2, verses 8 and 9. For it is by grace you have been saved through faith. And this is not from yourselves. It is the gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast. So, boys and girls, I love that verse, and I hope that you will memorize it, store it in your heart, and come to love that too, and understand the full meaning of it. Bye-bye for now.
Awesome job. Awesome job. Thank you guys so much for joining us today. And I hope you continue to practice your verses after camp two, because tomorrow we're going to review all three. Two things before we go. Has anybody done our extra camp song for the week? My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. It was our theme song for Team Kid this past year and my girls love it. So check it out if you haven't already. Also, each Wednesday, we're going to go on a virtual field trip, and today we're going to the Arctic to visit some polar bears. And this is a field trip that I'm pretty sure we would never actually get to go on in real life, right? So it's pretty cool. Go check both of those out, and we will see you back here tomorrow.